Alright folks, diving straight in, let's finish up this design. So we need some inputs with labels. And I know I've done some of this work already. So I'm going to just hide my pop-up for a second. And I want to have a look at my group settings. Please do the same. Find group settings and open group settings. So it's this group label and input that I'm after. And why don't we do this? Highlight group label and input, the first one with the first name and the input. Then head up to edit. And let's say convert to a reusable element. Type label and input. Then create. All right, then just bring up your property editor. And I just want you to clear out the expression in there. And we can actually, let's set the default builder width to about 200 here. That's just the build width, okay? Fantastic. Let's head back to the company page. Open up your pop-up. And now, if we scroll down, we can see that we have our reusable elements and we have a label and input. So click that and then just drop it beneath the summary. And this just saves us a little bit of design time, okay? What we need to do next is to actually detach it. Otherwise, it's going to be referencing the parent. So we're going to detach reusable element, and now we have basically our own instance in this pop-up that we can adapt how we see fit. It's now orphaned from its parent. Fantastic. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to say job title. And I'm then going to change the input name to job title. That is type text. Perfect. While we're here though, this time we are going to be configuring the initial content. But to do that, its parent needs a type of content with a data source. So now we're going to say job, and we're just going to reference the parent again, parent group's job. So later on, we'll be pushing data into the pop-up, and then this group, if it references the parent, well, it's referencing the data source. Here we go, parent group's job, which is the parent is the pop-up. And then in relation to this input, the parent is its group above. So I'm going to insert dynamic data and say parent group's jobs title. Okay, so you can see how we chain together data sources here. So we just keep referencing the parent, but data needs to start somewhere. Then it's being pushed into the pop-up. And then as long as all the child groups and elements reference the parent, it will basically find its way back to the pop-up as the data source. Okay, I'm going to copy and paste this. Copy, paste. Delete that section. Let's change this to term. And for term, we need a drop down here. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to say replace the element type. I'm going to look for a drop down. Replace. Okay, let's quickly set our style. Standard drop down. Fantastic. So it is a dynamic choice because it's an option set. So we have to point to the option set called term. The choices is all term because we have two. And then the current options display. So full time or part time. When it comes to editing a job, we need to see what the existing value is. So we're going to say parent group's jobs term. Make sure that this new label input has job set with parent group's job that should be inherited for when we copy and paste. Okay, I want these two next to each other because this is too much horizontal space. So we're going to highlight both. I can see one of them. Oh, never mind. I'm going to highlight both of these. And then, so both label and inputs, right-click, group elements in a row container. This can just be group inputs. And on the layout, we can choose, let's try 20. Yeah, that looks great. Okay, now we can highlight group inputs, copy and paste, clean it up. Now we have, I just want to check that also. Yeah, so just checking that we have job and the data source parent group's job, which we do. Okay, now we need work location. And for that, I need a dropdown. So I'm going to copy this one here. And I'm going to paste it inside labeled input and then just delete the input above it. And I'm going to choose, this time it's going to be location with all location and then parent groups jobs location. And I am going to just rename this to dropdown location. Let's just make sure we did the same for term, which we did in dropdown term. Okay, and down here on term, I need expires. And now we're going to change this again because I want a date time picker. So I'm going to right click, replace element type, look for date time picker, and replace. Okay, I don't think we have done a style for this yet. Let's just try standard. Not sure. Let's edit a standard date picker. So the date format, I want it to be friendlier. Let's choose the second one down. Going to say 500 medium. 16 inter would have inherited our text here. Leave the placeholder color. I might actually come back later on and just create a new placeholder color across the board. But for now, it's fine. Background style set to flat color and white. Border, let's set our border color here and set the roundness to 8. On the layout tab, let's choose 16 pixels left-right padding. And on the conditionals tab, remove the hovered, but keep the focused and the isn't valid. Okay, yeah, that looks much better. Okay, so let's take both of these group inputs. Right click, group elements in a column container. We're going to call this group summary. And on the layout tab, going to choose 20 pixels of row gap. Okay, I'm going to uncheck that this is visible in page load, and I'm going to collapse it when hidden. And on the conditionals tab, we're going to say that you can only see it when the popup state is summary. So popup job. Scroll down to the bottom, find tab, which is its state. Select is the first option, and then just type summary. That's when it's visible with a check. Okay, let's find a save button next. There's the button, just drop it towards the bottom. Simply going to say save. And now we're going to use our tertiary button here. Quick styling, let's make this edge to edge and remove them in width. And I like 44 for a button. Okay, great. Now for our description. So to design that, let's hide in the elements tree, hide group summary. And then let's go find this label input in the reusable elements section at the bottom. Click once, drop it on inside. I'm going to rename this whole group here to group description. So when the state is set to description, that's when we see this group. I'm going to remove its visible in page load, and I'm going to collapse it when hidden. Actually, before we go any further, let's just right-click on this group description and just make sure that we have detached it. Ah, so after I've done that, I can see that, bit of a bug there. So let's just bring this back into position. Group description, on the layout tab, I'm going to hit previous. Okay, so let's just have a look at these settings again. So not visible in page load, collapse when hidden, but we are going to see it when popups, jobs, when its custom state called tab is, then type out description. When that's the case, this element is visible. And if that doesn't work for you, it's because the state you're setting when you type the text in the workflow doesn't match this text here. It's case sensitive. Always check your spelling as well. Okay, instead of first name, let's type description. And instead of this input name first, just right click. Replace the element type. Type multi to get the multi-line input. And replace. Okay, and then let's set the initial content of, the data is something we need as well. So for group description, change it to a job and reference the parent group's job. So it's pulling data from the parent, which is the popup. So the initial content here would be the parent group's job's description. And let's change the style back to our standard multi-line input. Let's set the height to 88 pixels on the layout tab. Maybe let's do a bit more here. Let's do 128. Yep, just to make sure that this is a job, so it needs, you know, significant space, possibly way more than this, but this will just grow as a user types. So just to reiterate that this group description is not visible in page load. It's collapsed when hidden. And we bring it back when the popup jobs tab is description by clicking on this text element. Okay, let's check out the design on the front end. So new job, summary status set, so we can see the summary stuff here. Date and time picker, looks good. Description, yeah, really happy with that, guys. Really, really happy with that. Good amount of design work we did there. And in the next lesson, we're going to hook it up and start creating stuff. And that's when it gets really exciting. So take a break. I'm going to make a coffee and I'll see you in the next lesson.